how to be a winning horse player and making money in 2022. It is part five of a five-part series. This time around, we're going to take a look at bankroll, betting allocation, and how to approach the different wagers that are out there, ABC ticket construction. We've talked about that. But this is a very important and kind of a start of a new series of videos we're going to do on finding long shots, how to bet favorites, how to identify favorites, what does it mean when there's a horse at a lone speed, to try to get everybody, remember, be greedy when others are fearful, be fearful when others are greedy. And I think the lesson I learned from horse players is with all of these new wagers, people's bankrolls have risen. We've got less longtime players in the game, and we've got more new players in the game, but they don't quite know where to go on wagering strategies. Remember, we've got the other four parts of the series are already up. Betting strategies, caveman tickets, ABC ticket construction, and better horse racing betting. How to identify a win contender, and winning, picking winning horses versus horses that you think have a chance, and how to wager on those horses so that it reflects your stronger opinion. Now today, we're going to talk about bankroll size, what percentage of bankroll, long-term winning about your bankroll, and make sure to take a look at how your bankroll will go up and down over the course of the year. The portfolio of bets and takeout, very important as you start to look at some of these lower percentage win wagers like pick fives and pick sixes and pick fours, and what they can do to your bankroll over the long haul. Now, when you take a look at that, remember pick fives and pick sixes, these are low percentage wagers. Your bankroll will fluctuate. It amazes me that people will play three pick fives on a Saturday, which I only recommend two at the max, and that's only very rarely when you've got a couple of good cards going, because I just think realistically it's hard to handicap and ticket structure for multiple pick fives in a single day. It takes a lot of time, and remember, if you're spending a lot of that time handicapping, you've also got to allocate a percentage of that time towards ticket structure. Your bankroll will fluctuate, and remember in this, identify your favorites. Identify the races that you think can be part of your wagering strategy for that day. Now, your bankroll size, overall, the pick ends should be a smaller focus of your wagers. Focus in, unless you've got a larger bankroll, and I say that's over $1,000 on a Saturday, you should mainly focus in on exactas, daily doubles, and win betting, maybe some trifectas or 10 or 20 cent superfectas. But if you start betting one or two pick fives and a pick four, and you have less than $600 or $700 on your bankroll, it's going to eat up a large percentage of your bankroll. It's going to churn it out quicker. And if you hit any kind of losing skid, your bankroll will just dry up. And that's what's causing a lot of players out of the game. Also, a lot of players will get a lot of their wagers tied into these bets. And then if they lose in the fourth leg of a pick five, they may have already picked a couple of winners and they do not end up with any cash out of that sequence. So every sequence is different. Attack it from a optimal betting standpoint, and that includes taking some time to plan out your wagers at the beginning of the day. Also, play the track with smaller takeouts. Retama, Canterbury, Mahoning Valley. Look for those lower takeout pick fives. The early pick five at Santa Anita is lower takeout than the late pick five. Certain times of the year, other tracks have lower takeouts. Put that into your wagering mix, and also for win bets and exactas. Exactas and daily doubles can vary anywhere from 17% takeout to 25% takeout at some of these tracks. Another thing I see is that when you win money one day, you got to look at your bankroll for the year and your wagering for the either the meet or the season or the year. But don't look at it as a daily event. So if you win $7,000 on a pick five, which is a great score, congratulations, then what you have to do is realize that if you're playing pick fives and pick fours for the $100, $200 level, your bankroll might go back down. You might lose 10 straight $200 bets. It might go down to $5,000 before you hit another $1,000 pick five to get it back up to 6,000. And too many times I've seen people chase and try to win it all back on one race. So again, if you can hit 10% of your pick fives, you're doing well. If you can hit 20% of your pick fours, that is outstanding. Keep those benchmarks in mind. Also, I see people betting multiple tickets on the same sequence. So they'll play a pick five, they'll turn around and play a pick four. And then if they lose in that third leg, they're out on the pick five and the pick four. They've doubled down on their losses. And unless you can really flush out those situations where there's some opportunities, I think you're better served playing a win bet or an exacta bet inside some of those races. Also, betting a higher percentage of your money early on in the day can force some of those chase situations. So be aware that pick fives and pick sixes gives you a chance to see the scratches, see how the track is playing. But sometimes that first race of the day, there's less of the computer wagers and syndicates are in on those first couple of races of the day as well. So definitely take a look at the race that you're playing. Know the rules. This one comes about most recently with the Breeders' Cup. Gulfstream Park, it comes out a lot now with the synthetic course, in the past with the turf. You know, people don't look at the rules. You know, be aware that if a race is rained off or they take it off the turf or some bad weather comes up, that is why you are playing in blindly into these pools. These pools not only have a high takeout, you're taking in all of these other factors: weather, off the turf, synthetic surfaces, jockey changes, other situations that can cause a card to get canceled or postponed, weather delays, a rainstorm might pop up. That is what makes these bets even a lower win percentage. That's why I'm saying if you can win 10% of your pick fives, you're doing well. Also, if there's a late scratch, you can't change your pick five or your pick four. You get the betting favorite at some places. But also, then maybe then your selection is different and you have to kind of just be prepared to eat that ticket, go up there and bet a win wager or an exacta wager if the pace of the race changes. So you've got to be ready for changes. That's just part of the operating rules when you're playing these multi-race wagers. Now, again, one of the things I stressed, we're going to be talking more about this when we flesh out a couple of videos on how to pick long shots, but so many times I think people look at the current form, make their decision on a horse very fast. He's not any good. He's 10 lengths behind. He's 10 points lower on the buyer's scale. Look for reasons why a horse can win, because those are the horses that go off at longer odds. Those are the horses that you tend to leave off your tickets. Why are they in this race? What are they doing in this race? What conditions do they fit? Is there a jockey change? Is there a distance switch? Is there a surface change? Those are the factors that cause higher payoffs in these multi-race wagers. Be aware of them. And my main takeaway, as we want to all become better handicappers in 2022, the proliferation of pick fives and pick sixes, all of these jackpot wagers, that's the biggest reason why handle is down. People are putting more time and effort into these wagers. They've got higher takeouts, and that is getting less churn on the pool. Plus, people's money is tied up all day long. So the advantages of these large wagers, you can pay into the bigger pools on some big tracks, but don't forget about win wagering, exacta wagering. And remember, if you want to be in this for the long term, you have to find other ways to win on wagers, exactas, daily doubles, trifectas, and other wagers can also be part of your portfolio. Kind of have a portfolio of wagers. Don't be tied to just the pick five or the pick four. Look for ways when you have a winner or when you have an opinion. Sometimes that opinion is a horse that you think is going to lose the race. Be ready to just toss that horse out and then play other wagers to maximize that opinion. Maybe the horse is washed out in the post parade. Maybe he throws his rider right before the through the gate and then they don't scratch the horse. These are actually areas where you can actually make the track takeout right back to zero, get a plus expectation. And maybe you can't change your pick fives and pick fours, but you can pick another horse and recapture some of that bankroll. Remember, this series was a five-part series on videos. Make sure to watch the ABC method, caveman ticket, picking versus selecting, and bankroll ticket size. We've got more special series coming up. And Remember, leave your comments. What do you want to improve on as a handicapper? What are some of the ways that you play pick fives and pick fours? What have been your most successful wagers? Doubles, exactas? Leave a comment below. And if you have a question, we'll do a Ask Me Anything segment coming up soon on this entire series of videos. And remember, be fearful when others are greedy. Be greedy when others are fearful.